What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. In this episode of Journey to the American Passport, we're going to talk about how to prepare for your naturalization test. I'm going to share with you tips and tricks that I followed, and I'm going to show you exactly how you can prepare and successfully pass your test. In the previous episode, we talked about your biometrics interview. So when you go for your biometrics interview, they do give you a package, and one of the most useful things in this package is this little booklet to prepare for the naturalization test. So once you finish your biometrics interview, this is the right time for you to start preparing for your test, unless you do have more time to spare and you can pretty much start whenever you want. So this booklet has everything that you need in order to successfully pass the test if you do have a decent level of English. Now, when it comes to the test, there are two main portions. The first portion is English test, and the second one is the civics test. Now, for the English test, there are three main portions: reading, writing, and speaking. So for reading, your officer who's going to be interviewing you is going to test you in your reading ability. So basically, he will start with one simple sentence on a tablet. He's going to ask you to read. If you read it very well, he's going to move on to the next step. Otherwise, he's going to allow you for two more sentences to read. So pretty much three sentences. If you read one of them successfully, then you are good to go. And the reading section is very, very straightforward. In mine, they pretty much just ask me to read. Thanksgiving is a holiday. That's it. Now, the second portion is writing. You will be also asked, same concept, you will be asked to write one sentence. If you don't write it well, maybe second one and then third one. It's also a simple sentence, nothing complex. And then for the speaking category, it's nothing official. It's just that the officer who's going to be interviewing, based on the question, based on the interview, he's going to determine whether you are capable of speaking English. So that's pretty much it for the English test. It's very straightforward. There is even at the end of this booklet, there is a list of some vocabulary for places and holidays if you want to train, if your English is not that great. Now, the second portion of the test is the civics test. It's the one that takes a little bit of time. So the civics test basically covers important US history and government. Now, when you are preparing for the test, there are 100 questions that they pick from, and they do ask you, out of these 100 questions, they ask you 10 questions, random 10 questions, and you do have to answer 6 of them correctly. So, and I believe that this is a fair portion or percentage of passing or not passing. So 100 questions, you have to prepare for them. And all of these 100 questions are in this book. So if you cover all of the 100 questions, you are good to go. Now, the only thing is, for me personally, I don't like reading out of a book like this. So there is something called flashcards for citizenship exams. If you go to Amazon and you search for flashcards 2020 or flashcards 2021 for citizenship, you will find a set of them. They are very cheap. I don't have mine with me right now, but I do have some leftover cards, because when I finished my test, took Uber, and then the guy who was driving Uber, he was also going through naturalization, so I just give them away. But the cards look something like this, and it's a set of more than 100 of them. Some of them are just talking about the contact email for the company you get them from, what is citizenship, but then the rest of the deck of these cards are basically the 100 questions that you have to train on. One side of the card have the question, and then the other side has the answer. So the easiest way to do this is to train with someone and have someone ask you. So, and this is how I did it. I had the set of the flashcards, took them out for the first time, and I went through the questions one by one. And then I separated them into two piles. One pile, all of the questions that I already know, because to be fair, there are some questions that are very easy. What is the capital of the United States? How many states are there in the US? Who is the first president of the US? So some of these questions you might be already familiar with. So I've got one deck or one pile with all the cards that I already know. So I set them aside. I don't touch them for the training. And then I have another deck of cards that I don't know, or questions that I don't know. So I go through these from time to time, couple of days, just have someone ask me. And I really enjoyed the process. So Alex would ask me the questions, I would answer, and I felt like it was fun. It was fun to learn something new about this country, about the government, about the history. It was all fun. Now, there is one thing to keep in mind. There are some questions that are specific to your state. So for example, for me here in Arizona, there were some questions like, what is the capital of Arizona? What's the name of the governor of Arizona? Name one of the representatives from the House of Representatives of Arizona. Name one senator of Arizona. And some of these questions I was not familiar with, but with these flashcards, they actually allow you and they give you some space to write down the answer. So all you have to do, go online and search who is the governor of Arizona, for example, and then write it down on the flashcard, and then you just start practicing. So this is what I've been doing, just rounds of me going through the cards, which questions I know, which ones I don't know, and then when I train, okay, I'm familiar with these 20 additional cards, move them to the other pile, and so on. So just did that a couple of times, and obviously the 2 days before the actual test, and they do ask you fair questions, to be honest. During the interview, some of the questions are like very, very straightforward. I was asked why there are 50 stars in the flag, because there are 50 states. I was also asked the Declaration of Independence. I was asked, name one of the representatives from Arizona, which I did not know this answer before. I was asked about the two oceans in the US. So some questions are very straightforward. And this is pretty much everything that I did to prepare for the test. If you guys have any questions, please do let me know in a comment. We do answer every single comment within 24 hours. And if you did enjoy this video and found it to be useful, please give us a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. And again, the link to get the flashcards from Amazon is going to be in the description box. If you do purchase one, I'm going to get a bit of commission, and that's going to help me just keep making videos and probably getting better gear. So thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you very soon in the next episode, in which we will talk about things that you should do after you become a US citizen. Thank you again, and we'll talk to you very soon.